Today, colleges face tremendous financial, political, technological, and other complex challenges. As I start the process of applying for the job of college president, I wondered to myself, why would I want to become a college president? As I pondered that question, I thought back to a time when I walked this campus as a child and as a student. I remember my teachers and their dedication. I also remembered how excited I was to be right here at Kahoma. I sat in many of the same classrooms, and I learned firsthand how to go out into the world and continue to deliver what the world had to offer to a young Delta boy. Years later, I found myself being excited again about coming back to Kahoma. I knew the feeling I had as I placed my application in the mail. It was one of just knowing that this just feels right to come back home. I'm honored and I'm thrilled to be Kahoma Community College's fifth president because this is just such a good place. Not just with outstanding educators and traditionally rich athletic teams, musical performances such as you've heard today, and artistic accomplishments, but many special moments that make a difference in our lives. I am committed to working with the talented faculty and staff here, and I promise that we will continue to build on the legacy that began in 1949. In a beautiful lyrics by Dennis Brownie, in The Road Home is the phrase, "There is no such beauty as where you belong." The beautiful poem made me think of Kahoma as a place where faculty, staff, and I feel we belong, and where we all reach out to welcome students at home where they can come and grow and be nurtured. I offer these thoughts of Kahoma based not on generalities or aspirations, but based upon my own eye for detail, my careful listening to voices and sounds around me. I like to look close at things to understand them. Sometimes I move slowly to see the big picture, gathering all that there is to see. Inspired by a similar sense of what matters by the poet, Mary Oliver articulates so deftly in her poem, Messenger. My work is the loving world. Here the sunflowers, there the hummingbird, equal seekers of sweetness. Here the quickening yeast, there the blue plums. Here the clam deep in the speckled sand. Are my boots old? Is my coat torn? Am I no longer young and still half perfect? Let me keep my mind on what matters most, which is my work, which is mostly standing still and learning to be astonished. The people, the Nephilim, the sheep in the pasture, and the pasture itself, which is mostly rejoicing, since all the ingredients are here, which is gratitude to be given a mind and a heart and these body clothes, a mouth with which to give shouts of joy to the moth and the wren, to the sleeping dug up clam, telling them all over and over again how it is that we live forever. I have observed many things on campus the past few weeks that reminded me of the messenger. I have seen freshmen huddled together trying to figure out, do they belong here? I heard some talk of how difficult it is to be away from home for the first time. I saw a couple of sophomores trying to impress freshmen. I listened to the faculty as they explained to me the importance of assessment and student learning and working collaboratively. I was astonished about how enthusiastic our students are about being here and about how enthusiastic our faculty members are about teaching. All this has excited me about coming home to Kahoma. I have seen students go from frustration to understanding. I have seen and heard alumni getting ready for homecoming this week saying with pride, I am from Kahoma. I saw students working together in the library, overheard many interactions in the dining hall. I have seen students with funny looking clothes, piercings, tattoos. I've seen students who are dressed well enough to model for GQ. I've heard students who sing well enough to participate on The Voice. I've seen students dance well enough to audition for Dancing with the Stars, all sitting at the same table. They are such good people, good young people. I hope that you get a chance to interact with our students. When I stand still and see what is around me, I'm astonished, grateful, even rejoicing to see that all the ingredients are here to engage in the work of loving this particular world and the way it becomes a place of belonging and growing students. Kahoma's history is on a solid foundation. Kahoma Agricultural High School was established 89 years ago in 1924, becoming the first agricultural high school in Mississippi for African Americans under the existing separate but equal doctrine. The junior college curriculum was added in 1949, 64 years ago, and the name of the institution was changed to Kahoma Junior College and Agricultural High School. With the approval of the Board of Trustees of Kahoma Junior College and the State Board of Community and Junior Colleges, Kahoma Junior College's name was changed the year that I graduated in July of 1989 to Kahoma Community College. From the start, Kahoma has centered on learning. From humble beginnings, we have strived and survived in the Mississippi Delta. Kahoma has always been attentive to the ways of our students as it relates to how they learn and encourage personal growth, both in and out of the classroom. Kahoma graduates have gone on to emerge as leaders in all fields. Kahoma's spirit and originality still pervade our curriculum, and I'm encouraging our staff to continue this tradition. I want Kahoma to continue to grow by sitting down together to figure out how we can all solve all of our problems, whether it be budgetary or staffing problems. I think I'm uniquely poised. I knew President McLaurin vaguely. I knew James Earl Miller. I played in the office of McKinley C. Martin. I worked for and always admired Vivian M. Presley. Now it is our time, a new era. God bless you and God bless Kahoma Community College. Oh.